Buongiorno ragazzi, benvenuti alla prossima lezione di italiano. Hi everyone, welcome to your next online Italian lesson. Come stai? Tutto bene? I remember that I said I would always start by asking you that. Come stai? Meaning, how are you? For example, sto bene, sto molto bene, sto male, così così. All your typical responses. Tutto bene, just simply meaning, is everything okay? You may recall, andrà tutto bene in the logo was the slogan that's been adopted in Italy as a response to coronavirus. It's a message of hope, meaning that everything will be okay. So I hope you're all well. Hopefully today you will remember some of the vocab that you're going to see. The lesson is to do with the house, okay? It's connected to describing rooms. It's also got furniture in it. But the last time I finished a video lesson, I gave you these two words, meno, okay? And I said I would ask you what they would mean this time. So our start today is very simply cosa significa? What does it mean? Più, meno. Okay, so what do they mean? And then can you think of any times when you might use these expressions and you have used them before? Okay, allora una pausa se bisogna. So take a pause if you need to. You can stop the video at any time. So do that now if you just want to have a minute to think what these phrases mean and how you might use them. Va bene le risposte. Allora, in italiano più significa more, meno significa less, ok? Oppure più significa plus, meno significa minus, ok? Allora si può dire più e meno, meaning more and less, or plus and minus. There's two different translations of that depending on the context. So giving that away slightly. You've used these expressions before when we've done numbers. So with maths, if you were doing the sum 1 plus 2, you would say uno più due. Okay. Similarly, if you were doing 3 minus 1, tre meno uno. So that's one time you would use them. You've also used these before for descriptions. So saying I am taller than, okay, or I am shorter than. And the way you would do that would be by saying sono più grande. I am more tall, or sono meno grande, I am less tall. Okay, those are a couple of examples which may or may not be in your head from things that you've done in the past. Okay, allora la lezione di oggi, today's lesson. So, as I said, you're looking at places in the house, rooms, getting better at using adjectives and superlatives, superlatives meaning the most and the least, and hopefully being able to say what furniture is in your room. The orange box on the right-hand side has got some of the key vocab for today. So una stanza being a room, e meaning it is, più means more, and il or la più means the most, meno meaning less, and il or la meno meaning the least, and then some connectives which would be useful, e ma anche, inoltre. Ok, va bene. Va bene, allora cominciamo. Let's make a start then. So, first of all, I want you to have a little think about the phrases that you're about to see. Okay, you're going to have to decide what you think the phrases translate as. Okay, they're all using the words più or meno, and there's an adjective afterwards, which is something that you should have seen before. But depending on how recently you've looked at the vocab, you may or may not remember them. Okay, allora fa una pausa, so take a pause. And then when you unpause it, you will see all the answers. Va bene, risposte? Bigger, smaller, more beautiful, more funny, more intelligent. E poi, meno grande, meaning less big, okay, you might say smaller, less comfortable, less ugly, less clean. That was pulito, it doesn't mean polluted, okay? Some people often muddle that up. And meno disordinato, disordinato, meaning untidy. Ok, va bene. Allora, poi è più difficile questo esercizio. Ok, slightly harder, but the same task. This time it's all of the phrases you've just seen, but I've taken the Italian away. Ok, allora di nuovo fa una pausa. So take a pause. You can either write these or you can say them to yourself. When you unpause, you will have your answers. Le risposte allora, more big or bigger, più grande. Due, più piccolo. Tre, più bello. Quattro, più buffo. Cinque, più intelligente. Ok? Ora, numero sei, meno grande. Sette, meno comodo. 8 meno brutto, 9 meno pulito e numero 10 meno disordinato. Okay? Now, just as an aside, all of these adjectives are in the masculine form. Okay? They're all ending in either an E or an O. If you were describing something like a room, una stanza, okay, that's a feminine word because it's una and ends in an A, stanza, then you would actually change the endings of these. So the E still stays as an E, okay, that never changes, but piccolo would change to piccola, bello to bella, buffo to buffa, etc. Okay, so just be aware of that when you're describing things that you need to make sure adjectives agree with the thing that you're describing. Va bene, la mia camera è. So my room is. So here we go. Here's a feminine word, la camera. Okay, my room is. So describing things, positives and negatives. Grande e piccola. Okay, grande, un sinonimo, è spaziosa. Okay, a synonym would be spaziosa, spacious. But notice grande, piccola. Okay, I've changed it to the feminine word. So decide what your room is, and your answer would start with the phrase la mia camera è. So la mia camera è grande o la mia camera è piccola. Poi il prossimo, la mia camera è bella o la mia camera è brutta. So my room is beautiful, my room is ugly. Il prossimo, la mia camera è ordinata, tidy, o la mia camera è disordinata. Messy. Ok? E poi la mia camera è comoda, la mia camera è scomoda. Ok? So comfortable, uncomfortable. Again, ending in an A because it's la mia camera, all feminine. Il prossimo, la mia camera è pulita, la mia camera è sporca. My room is clean, my room is dirty. Ok? So the difference between pulita and sporca and ordinata, disordinata is more to do with tidiness and cleanliness. Okay, so you could obviously have a messy room, which isn't necessarily dirty. Okay, allora l'esercizio, trovate il contrario. So you need to find the opposites here. Okay, allora ci sono cinque frasi o cinque parole, five words. Trovate il contrario, find the opposites. Okay, fa una pausa, take a pause. Ok, le risposte. Numero 1, pulita. Pulita is clean. Il contrario è sporca. Ok, sporca, which is dirty. Numero 2, grande. Big. Il contrario, piccola. Small. Numero 3, bella. Il contrario è brutta. So beautiful and ugly. 4, comoda. Comfortable. Scomoda. Uncomfortable. E finalmente numero 5, ordinata, which is tidy. Il contrario è disordinata. Va bene. Ok. Allora, la più, la meno. Okay, we're saying the least and the most now. So più and meno, when you put the word la or il in front of it makes it the least and the most rather than just more and less. Okay? Allora, a la più sporca, it means the most, but can you remember what sporca meant? Che cos'è in inglese? Okay? So, can you work out which phrase on the left matches with the phrases on the right? Okay, va bene. Allora, ok, risposte. La più sporca in inglese, the most dirty. Allora, A2. B, la meno bella, the least beautiful. B5. Ok, B5, the least beautiful. Lettera C, la più pericolosa. Okay, that's got a star by it because it's a word which I wouldn't expect that many of you to remember at the moment. It means dangerous. Allora, C, sei, the most dangerous. Lettera D, la meno sicura. It looks similar to the English word secure. Okay, and if something is secure, it is safe. So la meno sicura is the least safe. E, la meno divertente, the least fun. F, la più noiosa, the most boring, allora F7. E finalmente G, la meno vivo, vivo connected to the word vivacious. If you are vivacious as a person, it means you are lively. So that is the translation you need. G1, la meno vivo, the least lively. Allora, dialogo. So it's the bottom half of what we're looking at here. Dialogo, com'è la tua città? So what's your city like? So we've got two parts, okay? I'm going to read them through once without changing anything, just so you can hear the pronunciation and also the intonation, okay? Because you'll notice in this conversation that it's actually to do with the way you are expressing yourself when you're reading it. If you read it with no expression in your voice at all, it won't actually make much sense, okay? And we'll look at why afterwards. Okay, ti piace Gateshead? Sì, mi piace abbastanza. Ci abito da sempre. Davvero? Ma sì, secondo me la cittadina è bella e abbastanza pulita. Non ci credo. Secondo me, Gateshead è la città la più sporca e la meno sicura della regione. Preferisco Newcastle. Ok, so you'll notice that the emphasis, the intonation came with these expressions. Davvero? Okay, now davvero, you may recognize the vero, which means true, and davvero as an expression means really or truly, because the person says in response to, do you like Gateshead? Yes, I quite like it, and the response they get is really. Okay, then I said ma sì in that way. Ma sì means well, yeah. Okay, so the person is responding in a way that is communicating the fact that, well, yeah, that's what I think. Ma sì. Secondo me la cittadina è bella e abbastanza pulita. So they qualify that by saying, in my opinion, secondo me, the town is beautiful and quite clean. Okay, remember, abbastanza meaning quite. Then we get another response which needs to have some clear intonation. Non ci credo, which means I can't believe that. Okay, non ci credo. And the reason why is, secondo me, Gateshead è la città la più sporca e la meno sicura della regione. So Gateshead is the most dirty city and the least safe in the area. Okay, preferisco Newcastle. I prefer Newcastle. So the expressions that are new here for you are davvero and ma sì and for and non ci credo. Okay, you should hopefully remember secondo me, but if not, then that's an expression which you need to start using more frequently. It means in my opinion. Okay. Right, so that's the conversation that is already there for you. You can see that there are numbers, uno, due, tre, quattro, cinque, five words or sections that you need to change. So when you get to ci abito da sempre, you would need to change da sempre to the expression that means one year, okay, for the first conversation. Numero due, instead of saying the town is beautiful, la cittadina è bella, you would change it to the word that means quiet. Numero tre, pulita, would change to the word that means pretty. Quattro, sporca, would change to ugly. And the final one, cinque, would also be pretty. Okay, so that would be if you were doing conversation one. What I'd suggest you do is you have a go at doing this. Now, read it out. Okay, you might feel a bit daft reading both parts, but it's important that you practice the intonation. Alternatively, if you know someone who could do the lesson at the same time as you, then you could be speaking to them and doing it as a pair. Final option is to do it as a written task, okay? So to spend some time putting your answers together and then seeing whether or not what you've written down matches the answers that you look at. So remember, if you are wanting to do it as a task where you're trying to remember stuff, then I would suggest you do it without any help, okay? So try not to look back at anything. If you're really struggling, then obviously you have the option to have a little look back, okay, at some of the words that we were seeing before, so going back in the video. Okay, allora fa una pausa, take a pause, take as much time as you need, and then after that we'll come back and look at some of the answers. Okay, va bene, risposte. So you should, if you've not already been looking back at these, now be able to see how you've got on, remembering that they match up. Okay, so this is what you saw in the conversation you were working through, this box at the top, and underneath these are the answers. So you may, for example, not have remembered the word for a week. Okay, so 1 week is una settimana, 9 weeks would be 9 settimane. Okay, have a look through now, see how you got on. If you really struggled with that, then it's probably a case of you needing to go back and revise some of the adjectives. Okay, so words like safe, dangerous, clean, dirty, lively. Ok, va bene. Continuiamo.
Let's carry on then. And before we move on completely, okay, if you've not already done this, if you've not had time yet, then this is the chance to do so. Scrivi un dialogo per te. So you're going to go back to the video, have a look at the conversation you've been working through, where you're basically arguing with someone about what a place is like. Follow the example conversation that I've given you, but feel free to add more if you want. Okay, so you're going to be talking about a place and saying what you think about it. The vocab, a reminder, davvero meant really or truly, secondo me, in my opinion, non ci credo meant I don't believe it. The only other one that I mentioned was ma sì. It's not really that difficult, but ma sì kind of meant well, yeah. Okay, allora, fa un dialogo per te. So write your own dialogue. Fa una pausa se bisogna. So take a pause now, you'll need it. So you can write your own conversation down. And this is something where if you wanted to send it to me, then obviously feel free to do so. Okay, allora, la lezione di oggi. So this was today's lesson. We've covered the first aspect of it, so looking at adjectives, superlatives. Second part of the lesson, la seconda parte, furniture. Okay, now you may well have in previous lessons worked through exercises to do with furniture. If you have, then this is a recap. And if you haven't, then this is a chance to start learning that vocab now. Okay, nella mia camera ho. Okay, la frase qua, nella mia camera ho, in my room I have. Okay, so some items you may have in your room, un tappeto, okay, a rug. Ascoltate e ripetete. So as you would in lesson, listen and repeat as you see these, un tappeto, un computer. Un armadio, un cassettone, un letto, uno scaffale, uno stereo, una scrivania, femminile, feminine word, una scrivania, a desk, una sedia, una lampada. Now on to plurals, dei poster, posters. Dei dischi. Okay, CDs becoming a less frequent thing to have these days, but there we are, dei dischi are CDs. Okay, allora, nella mia camera ho, this is what you're going to have to do next. Try and work out what letters are missing, che lettere mancano. So I would suggest you take a minute, okay, practice remembering what these all are. Fa una pausa, pause there, and then when you unpause, you'll be able to complete the next task. Ok, nella mia camera ho, allora numero uno è uno scaffale, CL. Numero due, un computer, CP. Numero tre, scrivania, CV. Numero quattro, sedia, SA. Cinque, tappeto, PO. Numero sei, armadio, lettera D. Numero sette, dei dischi, lettera D. Numero 8, uno stereo, TE. Numero 9, dei poster, PT. 9, una lampada, M. Scusa, numero 11, un cassettone, allora SN. E finalmente un letto, L. Va bene? Ok, allora, ora scrivete velocemente. Ok, now you're going to have to write these as fast as you can. Okay, so grab yourself a pen if you haven't already got one. Bisogna una penna. Okay, and you have to basically write and keep up with the answers as they come up. Okay, I will not be giving you very long, so it's speed writing. You write them as quickly as you can. Okay, and we'll see how many of them you know. Okay, va bene. Allora, tre, due, uno. Okay. So see how quickly you can write them, as many as you can. Tre, due, uno, zero. Un letto. Un armadio. Un cassettone. Un computer. Un tappeto. Uno scaffale. Uno stereo. Una scrivania, una sedia, una lampada, dei dei dischi, dei poster. Ecco. Okay, that's all your answers. So it doesn't matter how neat your writing was, it's about how many of them you could remember. So that is your entire list: un letto, un armadio, un cassettone, un computer, un tappeto, uno scaffale, uno stereo, una scrivania, una sedia, una lampada, dei dischi, dei poster. Ok, va bene? Ok, nella mia camera. Oh, so what do you have in your room? So you can obviously use the word ho, which means I have, then develop it anche ho, also I have. Or the other connective we saw earlier on was inoltre, which means furthermore. Ma non ho, but I don't have. And vorrei, I would like. Okay, so you can see all of the images there. So you're gonna just describe your room now. Okay, so have a look around it if you are already in it. Vorrei, what you would like. So if you don't have it, you might say, E vorrei una scrivania, and I would like a desk. Okay, fa una pausa. Hopefully you've managed to describe what's in your room. You may have extra things, but that's fine. In terms of describing your room, these are some of the phrases you may have been saying. Okay, so I have a bed, I have a wardrobe, I don't have a shelf. Remembering that in Italian, the word non at the front makes the phrase negative. Allora, come si dice? I have a bed. Ho un letto. I have a wardrobe. Ho un armadio. Tre, non ho uno scaffale. 4. Non ho uno stereo. Ho una sedia. Anche ho uno stereo e un computer. Ho una scrivania, ma non ho una sedia. Ok, va bene? Ok, una domanda, question for you. What words can you use instead of ho to describe what there is in your room? Ho meaning I have. Okay, now some of you may remember the word c'è. Okay, c'è means there is. So if you get bored of saying oh, non oh, then you can use c'è, spelled C apostrophe E with an accent on it, and c'è means there is. Okay, esercizi nella mia camera. So there are some exercises for you to do now. Exercises 1 and 2. Esercizio 1, abbina l'immagine e la parola. So it's a match up with the image and the word. Esercizio 2, metti le parole in categorie. So putting the words into categories. Ok, vediamo. Ok, va bene, primo esercizio. There's our first exercise. Ok, allora ci sono 10 immagini, 10 parole. Ok, 10 images and, sorry, 12 images, losing sight of the bottom two. Match them up. You can see the first one is done for you. Numero uno, lettera B, un letto. Okay, fa una pausa. Take a pause as long as you need to do that exercise. Answers when you unpause. Okay, le risposte. Numero due, questo è numero due, e la risposta è lettera A, dei poster, 2A. Numero 3 è uno stereo, allora 3H. Numero 4 è una sedia, allora 5, 4L. Numero 5 è un computer, allora 5D. Numero 6 un armadio, G. Numero 7 è una scrivania, ilunga. 8 è un cassettone, F. 9 un tappeto, I. 10 uno scaffale, C. 11 una lampada, allora lettera E. E finalmente 12 dei dischi, K. Ok, finito. Prossimo esercizio. Next exercise. Looking at those words and trying to decide, are they masculine words, feminine, or are they plural? Okay, you can jot yourself down a table that looks like this if you wish. Maschile, femminile, plurale. Masculine, feminine, plural. And obviously, you need to know what you're looking for. So you need to think, what does a feminine word look like? What does a masculine word look like? What is the thing that gives it away as being a plural word? Okay. If you know that, perfect. Okay, you can do the exercise quickly and you can pause this now. If you didn't know, then here's your description of how you know. Okay, with masculine words, they start with either un or uno. And the thing that to look out for is usually an O on the end of the word for masculine words or an E. The only time here that this doesn't match up is because they've taken the English word computer and they've used it in their own language. But usually the rule, if it's a singular word, one thing, and it's masculine, it will end in an O or sometimes an E. Okay, allora, le parole maschili, okay, the masculine words, therefore, that are singular, we would have had un letto, uno scaffale, un computer, un cassettone, un armadio, uno stereo, un tappeto. Okay, all of those would have fit into your first column. Femminile, okay, your feminine words where they are singular, so just one of them, it's an una that you're looking for at the front. That means a or one. And the last letter is an A or sometimes an E, okay? So our answers for feminine words, therefore, there aren't many of them. Una lampada, una scrivania, una sedia. Plurale, okay, plurals, things where there's more than one of them. So you can see that we've only got a couple left. Dei poster, which means some posters. That's what dei means. And dei dischi, which means some CDs. Ok, perfetto. Ok, continuiamo e facciamo un po' di lavoro orale, ok, speaking task, lavoro orale. Che c'è nella tua camera da letto? So what is there in your bedroom? Ok, allora, nella mia camera da letto c'è o ho un letto. Nella mia camera da letto c'è un letto e un armadio. Nella mia camera da letto ho un letto e un armadio e un computer. Ok? E continua così. And it carries on like that. So it's a memory game. Ok, ideally this would work best with a partner. So as I said, if you can do this lesson at the same time as somebody else, then you can do this as a competitive thing where one of you adds one on and the other person has to remember it and you keep going until someone forgets what the items were and what order they were in. Alternatively, you can just use this as a way of practicing the vocab. So go back a few slides if you need to try and remember what all of the vocab is. So using the phrase nella mia camera da letto ho, in my room I have. Ok, va bene. Ok, un po' di lavoro orale di nuovo. Ok, it's a bit more oral work. Ok, facciamo una descrizione della camera. So doing a description, una descrizione della camera of the room. Ok, allora si può dire è, o, non ho. So to describe this room, okay, è would obviously need an adjective after it. So I would say something like è disordinata, it's messy. O, what you have, un letto, un cassettone, okay, that would be fine, just a couple of items. Non ho una scrivania, I don't have a desk, okay? So that would be an easy way of describing that room, what it's like, what you have in it, and what you don't have, okay? So you can redo that one, or alternatively, if you think that that's easy and you'd be able to do it with no problem, we can carry into the next ones. Each time you see an image, pause it to describe it and then listen to my description to see whether or not you've kind of got the idea. Okay, come la camera numero due. La camera è bella, è pulita, è ordinata. So it's clean, it's tidy, it's beautiful. Ho due letti e un cassettone. I have two beds and a chest of drawers. Non ho un tappeto. I don't have a rug. Obviously, lots of other things you could say you don't have. Okay, come la camera. Okay, la risposta è la camera è sporca, è brutta, so ugly and dirty. Ho un cassettone, ho due letti e uno stereo. Non ho dei dischi, I haven't got any CDs, ok? Il prossimo, come la camera? Ok, another messy one. La camera è disordinata, è brutta, ho un letto e ho anche una lampada e ho dei libri, Okay, I've got books, you know that word before libri. Non ho un armadio. Okay, I haven't got a wardrobe, at least not one that I can see. Okay, final one for you. Come la camera? Ok, la camera è bella, è ordinata, è pulita, so it's clean and tidy, it's quite pretty. Ho un letto e anche ho dei cuscini. Okay, that's the word for cushions. Cuscini e una sveglia e una lampada. Non ho un tappeto, ho un armadio. I haven't got a rug or a wardrobe. Okay, finalmente ascoltate che camera è. Okay, so you're going to listen out and work out which room it is that I am describing, A, B, C, or D. Okay, numero uno. La mia camera è molto disordinata. Ho una sedia e una lampada e uno stereo. Due. Nella mia camera ho due letti e la camera è molto pulita. 3. Nella mia camera c'è un letto e un cassettone e un po' disordinata. Numero 4. Nella mia camera ci sono due letti e la camera è sporca. Okay, obviously you can go back, re-listen to that if you need to. Okay, le risposte, your answers, 1, D, 2, B, 3, A, 4, C. Ripeto, 1, D, 2, B, 3, A, 4, C. Va bene, per finire un esercizio di lettura. Ok, leggete. You're going to do a bit of reading now. This is the final part of the task to see whether or not you've understood adjectives and items of furniture in a room. Allora, leggete la descrizione e completate la tabella. Ok, so you're going to read the descriptions and fill in a table. It's a tick box kind of table. You can see at the bottom that there are images. So there's a bed, there's a desk, a chair, a chest of drawers, a wardrobe, a computer, and then a box that says altro or aggettivi. So for each person, for Sabrina, Luca and Lina, you need to draw yourself in the table. Okay, their names on the left hand side. I'll just go down slightly so you can see what it would be like if you were working on a worksheet at home. Okay, so there we go. So just make sure your table has got their names underneath. And then tick or cross the items that they have. And then in the box at the end, if there's anything else that you've understood that they have, or if you can write down what the adjectives are in English that they use to describe their rooms, if they say it's pretty, messy, clean, okay, then that's where they would go. So it's really to test your understanding. The simplest part of the task is just ticking or crossing the items. The more complex part is adding on the extra information at the end, the extra things they have, and describing what the room is like. Just so that you know, there are also a couple of phrases in here where they're saying what they would like in future. Okay, so someone talks about what they would like for their birthday, someone talks about what they would like for Christmas. So just be aware, okay, that doesn't necessarily mean that they have the item already. They might be saying what they want. Ok, fa una pausa e poi vediamo le risposte. Let's take a pause and then we'll look at the answers. Ok, risposte. Vediamo prima di tutto Sabrina. So let's look at Sabrina first of all. What I'll do is I'll take it from the top and I'll translate it so you can look at what you've understood out of all of this. So it means my room is big and red. So those are adjectives. La condivido con la mia sorella. So shares it with her sister. Quindi è molto disordinato, therefore it's very messy. That would be an adjective. Here's what she has. Okay, so you should have ticked bed, wardrobe, computer. She also has a stereo and lots of CDs. Okay, this is the one where she says what she would like. Mi piacerebbe, I would like a TV in future, possibly for Christmas. Okay, so she didn't already have one, she would like one. Luca, He gives an opinion. Mi piace molto la mia camera. I really like my room. Because. Perché. And then the adjectives you should have noted down are beautiful, modern, and also he says he doesn't share it. Things that he has, so you should have ticked a bed, chest of drawers, desk, computer, and a chair. Other things that you could have written in the last box, posters, okay. Le parete are the walls, okay. So he's saying the walls are black and white. So you might remember nero with an O on the end for black, but because it's le parete, which is plural, it goes to nere e bianche. This one here, you probably wouldn't know it, but una bella pianta is a pretty plant, okay. Lina, so Lina's room, she says, her room is small but tidy and comfortable. It's blue, azura. The things that she has, you should tick a bed, wardrobe, shelves, and crosses under stereo and a computer. Well, there isn't a picture of a stereo, but if you've written that down, that's what she doesn't have. And sarebbe bello means it would be lovely. So it would be great to have a computer for my birthday. Okay, so that's what Lina would like. Okay, quasi finito, so nearly finished. Before the next lesson, spend some time revising furniture on educandy.com. When you go to the website, just type in the code 1A9E2, okay? That will take you to the exercises. And then once you've spent some time practicing those and learning them, set yourself a little vocab test and you can see how well you know them. In terms of other things, I mentioned lockdown bingo. You should hopefully have seen last week that this was part of the lesson I asked you to do. So there is a grid, okay? You need to choose from the grid something to do. Each time you do a task and you have got some evidence of having done it, whether that be photo, audio, video, paper, then you need to keep it or ideally send it in to me so I can see it. Use the MFL help address to Hewith, and I will pick that up. And for every task you complete, you will be entered into the competition to become the lockdown bingo champion. So please take part. It would be nice to see that people are joining in and doing something that's a bit different. So it may well be that you listen to some Italian songs, you watch some TV, and maybe you do a dance workout or you go on and do some tongue twisters, but choose whatever you fancy and let me see what you've done. So that is it for this week. Abbiamo finito. Okay, I hope you've had a good lesson. I hope you have a good week and I will see you soon. Okay, ciao ragazzi, ciao ciao.